Hi, everyone. Good morning. Let's take a look at your first pitch forecast for the Barnstormers playing the Revolution tonight. Home in Lancaster, we have first pitch at 7 o'clock, and temperatures around then will be in the upper 70s, I think, for the most part. We'll see some sunshine later today. Can't rule out an isolated thunderstorm, but most of that activity will be winding down before the game. Let's go to the News 8 Storm Team forecast for you today. We're looking for morning clouds, some haze out there, even a couple of spotty showers. For the afternoon, we'll see more sun than we did yesterday. Warm and humid, that's for certain. And look at these summer-like temperatures, 82 to 86 degrees. Our average high for this time of the year is around 70. Tonight, mostly cloudy, muggy, a shower or thunderstorm can't be ruled out. Overnight lows will be generally in the 50s. Then for tomorrow, a little change in the wind direction. We'll see more of an easterly flow in the morning, and that's going to bring in some marine clouds. Those clouds are low and thick, so a lot of cloud cover to start the day. It may look a little gloomy. I think the clouds will peel back, though, slowly by afternoon, but the damage will be done to our temperatures. We'll stay in the 70s tomorrow. Live right now in Harrisburg, here's some of that haze I was talking about. Kind of some cloudy, hazy conditions. A little bit of sun peeking through, though. Let me show you the current visibility in miles here. We have fairly good visibility, but in Lancaster, you can only see a mile and a half in front of you. Reading, only 2.5 mile visibility. For Coatesville, it's about 3 miles. So that haze putting a little damper on your morning commute. Current temperature check, 59 in Lebanon, 57 for Pottsville. Check out Lancaster at 59 degrees, while Gettysburg and Chambersburg are a bit warmer. You folks both saw some stray morning showers or some sprinkles there, just enough to wet the roads, really. Live on Super Doppler 8, most of that shower activity has quieted down. Didn't make it east of the river too far. You can see some more showers, even some thunderstorms ongoing north of I-80, right across the northern tier of the Commonwealth, and most of that won't reach us. It could clip our northernmost counties, though, this morning. Bigger picture shows a cold front stretched out from Chicago down toward Houston. Look at that rain in Texas. Some flooding concerns there. A lot of rain all at once. Now, this front will be coming in our neck of the woods, but not until Friday. It's going to take its good old time getting here. So ahead of that front, we'll deal with several different weather scenarios. Let me take you through the next 48 hours. For today, I think we'll see a stray shower or thunderstorm later on in the afternoon, but they should be fairly isolated. Tonight, this cold front sags in, and we get that easterly flow coming right in off the ocean. That's going to pack in the clouds for us tomorrow morning, and they'll be slow to retreat tomorrow afternoon. Could have a few showers late tomorrow, but I think we're mainly dry on Thursday. Thursday's going to be a warm day, and a windy one, too, ahead of the strong cold front, which will finally deliver some rain for us by Friday, and it could be a good soaking, too. Here's the extended forecast. Today we're at 84 degrees, stray shower or thunderstorm after we clear out of the morning clouds, and spotty showers. Tomorrow we are cooler due to more cloud cover and easterly flow, 74 degrees. Back up to 80 on Thursday, and rain likely as that front comes in on Friday. How about the weekend, guys? Look at that, cooler.
Yeah,
70s, 60s, with lows back in the 40s, so a little better for sleeping weather there by the weekend, not as sticky.
15 degrees or more below what we're seeing today and yesterday.
All right, thank you, Christine.
Thanks, Christine.